My name is Dr. Steve Maxner. I'm the director of the Vietnam Center and Archive at Texas Tech University. The Vietnam Center and Archive have a number of interesting national security and national defense implications. I think at the micro level, there are a number of important issues we've helped the military and the Department of Defense address. And very specifically, in recent years, as the United States has become involved in Iraq and Afghanistan, the resources of the Vietnam Archive have become important in developing new policies and strategies as we've engaged in combat operations in that theater. Now, the Vietnam Center and Archive have the largest collection of Vietnam War-related materials outside the National Archives, with about 25 million pages of material. And of that, we have approximately 3.3 million pages available online in our virtual archive. And for example, when the United States Navy needed to address the issue of riverine warfare in Iraq, and they were seeking information about past historical examples of those kinds of operations, when they approached Washington, D.C. and tried to find the materials they needed to better inform policy in Iraq, they weren't able to find them easily. And when we learned of that issue, we were able to provide them with literally hundreds of historical documents from the Vietnam War that helped the commander of Naval Expeditionary Combat Command and his officers and his NCOs develop the policies and the strategies necessary so they could develop a better and a safer policy for our sailors fighting in Iraq. The same has happened in places like Afghanistan, where Vietnam Center and Archive resources have been used to help develop a better training policy for military advisors who have gone to both of those countries and trained the military and police forces. The Vietnam Center and Archive also work with DPMO, Defense Prisoner of War Missing Personnel Office, in providing assistance to researchers as the United States is still accounting for missing from that conflict. As a result of the historical resources we have available both in our archive and online in our virtual archive, researchers have found documents that have allowed them to take action on both last known alive cases as well as cold cases so that our nation can have a full accounting of our missing from the Vietnam War. In addition to that, the Vietnam Center and Archive contribute to our nation's understanding of the contributions of our veterans in times of war, in times of national need. And I think at a macro level, that's probably one of the most significant things that we can provide. We have the historical materials available so that scholars and researchers around the country can write texts and books about the war. But in addition to that, we host conferences and other activities that do contribute to our nation's understanding of the Vietnam War and gain a better appreciation for what our American veterans have done for our country. Along those lines, we're also working on collecting and preserving the history of contemporary veterans who have been fighting in places like Iraq and Afghanistan. And we have an archive dedicated to conflicts since 1975. This is in its fledgling stages, but we think this is going to be equally important in the future as our nation looks back on the conflict since Vietnam and has many of the same questions. You know, why were we there? Why were we fighting? And was it worth it? And I think, and of course, how do we show appreciation to our nation's veterans? And I think that this archive is going to be just as important for the future as our Vietnam archive is today.